Hey everyone, Alex here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about how to build a screech owl house for your backyard. If this is your first time visiting my channel, feel free to browse all the videos, and if you like what you see, please hit that thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so before we begin, let's talk a little bit about safety. You're going to be using a power saw or maybe a battery pack saw. I don't know what kind of saw you're going to be using to cut your board, but safety is the priority. So let's talk about that. When you're cutting, it's going to make a lot of noise. If you're in an enclosed area, wear one of these earmuffs because the noise can make you feel like, wow, it can take your hearing away. You don't want to lose your hearing at a young age, so wear earmuffs or earplugs, either of your choice. Optional is gloves. You can wear gloves. I particularly do not like to wear gloves because I like to feel around what I'm doing. All right, but that's your choice. And because you're going to be working around a lot of dust, make sure you wear your dust mask. Okay, that's going to be very important whenever you're drilling. Now, well, not just drilling, but sawing as well. Okay, so safety glasses. That's the number one feature you need to have on your eyes. Friends, please wear your safety glasses. Protect your eyes whenever you're doing any type of cutting of wood or any type of things you're doing, especially when it comes to building things. Now, what I like to do too, not only put on my eye goggles, but I also like to put on a face mask. This is a cheap face mask that you can purchase online on Amazon. This is the type of mask people are using these days because of the coronavirus. I particularly use it because I just don't want the dust hitting my face. And even though I'm wearing my dust mask and even though I'm wearing my safety goggles, I just don't like dust in my face. So I'll just wear these. It fits perfectly over my head. Okay. You're going to need tools, right? Tools is a needed thing to have whenever you're working with woodwork. I have power drills. I particularly use two, and the reason why is because one's to pre-drill the wood, the other one's to screw in the screws. You're going to need screws, wood screws. Preferably the screws that you're going to be needing is the outdoor screws. Let me get these real quick. These are the exterior outdoor screws. So these are 2-inch screws that you're going to be using to mount the boards together. Other tools you're going to need to use is a measuring tape. You're going to need to use a square because you're going to want to angle your roof whenever you're cutting. So make sure that you're angling, make sure that your square is at least 12 inches. So because what we're going to be doing is cutting 10-inch board. So make sure that you have enough square to use whenever you line up your boards. Okay, so speaking of boards, so let's get to that. Okay, so here's the board that I'm going to be using. I'm going to be using a 1x8x10 pine board. And just to let you know, this is a real tall board. Now, I would recommend that if you're gonna buy a board of this size at your local hardware store, definitely have them pre-cut your board at least by 4 feet, because what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna first of all do your own cutting, but you also want to make sure that this is going to fit your vehicle. Okay, so I already measured my board, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to link down below the actual plan for this house of the screech owl. It could be useful for the American kestrel as well, but for this video, in this purpose of the video, we're going to go ahead and make it for a screech owl house. And I forgot to mention one other thing that you're going to need for the hole itself. Make sure that you get a saw bit, okay, for your drill, power drill, and it's a 3-inch saw bit, so make sure you get that. That's important, otherwise the bird is not going to go inside the house. So when you download the plans, it's not going to tell you, I had to pre-write this down myself, so it's not going to tell you what these boards are for. The only thing it's going to say is roof. I pretty much manually put in what it's for. So these are the sides. This is the floor. Keep in mind, the sides is going to be 16 1/4 inch on the back side. The front side is going to be 15 1/4 inch on both sides. Okay, so two sides, those are the measurements. The floor is going to be 8 1/4 inch Okay, so keep that in mind. The back is going to be 26 and a quarter inch long, okay? And then, of course, the front is going to be 15 and a half inches. And then the roof is going to be 14 inches. Now, you're going to have leftover wood, which is when I measured it, pre-measured it. I'm going to not throw away any part of this wood. I'm going to use this for the perch on the inside of the front house so that when the bird leaps to get out of the house, it can use the perch, especially for the babies. And so since I already pre-measured my board, I just want to go over something with you. Just make sure that you run your measurement from bottom to the top. Line it up pretty good. Now, since this board is a sideboard of the house, it's going to be cut in an angle, okay? So make sure you use your square. Once you measured your board first, 15 and a quarter inch, I believe it is, and then 16 and a quarter inch. Once you measure that, you'll put a little dot there. Then you'll take your square, and then you'll line it from dot to dot. And that way you can get your line in. Again, this is going to be both sides of the Screech Owl house. So before you're doing the sides, you'll want to get all your straight cuts first. I like to hold my saw down until it completely stops instead of just bringing it up, because the blade continues to spin, and if it gets caught in your wood, it's going to flip, and that has happened to me before, and don't want that happening again. It's a little scary. I've written what the boards were for in small letters. Front, sides, back, roof. This is going to go on the inside anyway of the birdhouse, so it doesn't really matter. But this helps me to know, reference point wise, what belongs to what. Like, this is going to be the back. So, and I'm going to now take, this is the front, so I'm going to take that perch right off. Save that for last, because that's a small piece. There we go, straight cut. Love it. There you go. So now you know what I'm talking about. You have the hole here, and then you put the perch right here underneath the hole. You can glue that in with wood glue. I would just do that. And if you want to use a inch and a quarter screw, that's fine too. You could do both sides, either or. Okay, so I'm gonna save these now. And now I'm gonna cut the side. Save the best for last, right? Okay, so I want to show you something real quick. Now, the procedure on the instructions to cut the floor was 8 inches, but this is what I'm finding. When I line up my house, my side to the backboard, the floor is supposed to be like right here. Now, if I lay it this way, it would have been a perfect fit, but notice it's got a big gap right here. So what I'm going to do is basically flip it over just like this. Now, if I flip it over, I'm not going to have enough to screw in anything. So what I'm going to have to do is now cut to place the board on the inside, to slide it inside instead of having it overlapped on the outside. So what I'm going to do, I'll line it up just like this. I'll make sure that my sides are lined up first. Make sure that it's really flush to the end, okay? You don't want to measure out anything until your walls on the side wall is flush to the back. And once you do that, you're just going to go ahead and place your floor right underneath the actual side of the house and make it really nice and flush. Now, once you do that, once you make it nice and flush, now you could take a pencil and draw a line from the inside. And then once you draw your line on the inside, you'll see that's what you need to cut. Clear? Okay, so now the fun part, pre-assembling. Okay, so now that you have all your cuts, it's time to put it together. All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna lay the back part first onto the floor. I'm gonna go ahead and put the sides up, okay? I'm gonna make sure that I have enough lip on the bottom and top because I'm gonna be setting brackets to put up against the tree when I drill it to the tree. I'll take this here. All right, put this here. Now I'm gonna put the floor right inside. Okay, this could be a little tricky, guys, a little tricky. Whatever you do, don't mount screws on the floor on the front side, okay? You're only gonna do it on the sides. I'll show you in a sec. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the front on here, make it nice and level. It's right now like a puzzle. You don't wanna drop it because nothing's in place. And because this is pine, you don't want to be so harsh on your screwing into your screw because pine tends to split. So you want to be real easy, just like that. Don't be too harsh on it. Okay, so that's one. I'm going to put 1, 2, 3, 4 because the front panel is what's going to come out whenever you're ready to clean your birdhouse. Okay, so now it's time to put it on the floor. Now, because I screwed the house, the sides to the back and front, it might be a little tight to go ahead and put in. If that's the case for you, you may have to just play with it just for a little bit. And so what I do is basically, I'll take a rubber hammer and just basically play with it until you get it in. Not so hard because you don't want to overlap inside. Just make it nice and flush. It's almost tight enough to leave it in there without screwing, but that's not what we're going to do. All right. So what we're going to do now that everything's nice and flush, we are not going to put screws on the front, okay? Because remember, when you're ready to clean the birdhouse at the non-season nesting season, you're only going to remove these four screws, pull it out, clean it out, put it back in, that's it. Okay, so now it's time to make the entrance hole. Now, what I do is take the measuring tape from the top of the house and just come down to 4 inches. Once you come down to 4 inches, just put a little mark on there and then take your drill bit and center it. That's where you're going to make the entrance hole. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is make drainage holes on the bottom, okay? So all I do is like a dice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So one being in the middle. All right, guys, that's it for my video. I hope you found it helpful. If you thought it was helpful and you like what you saw, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe to my channel because I'm always uploading some new videos of different things. So this is your Screech Owl House. It's ready to be hung. And yeah, and if you prefer to put the little perch on, just like that, you could glue it on, screw it on, make sure it's about a 1/4-inch screw. That way it don't pierce through the panel. But you can also place it on the inside as well, so that way the baby bird tries to climb up, he has something to grab onto. Anyway, and one thing I want to mention that I didn't mention before, make sure that your entrance hole is 3 inches in diameter, if I haven't brought that up already. That's very important. Anything smaller, it won't go in. So yeah, so have fun. I hope you attract some screech owls to your backyard. This is the way to do it. Till my next video, guys. See ya.